Today we're in Fort Chipewyan, Alberta. We're working with the local communities and doing dissections of some of the samples that were collected on the land by traditional land users. So the work that we do is part of the oil sands monitoring program, and it feeds into Environment and Climate Change Canada's mandate to protect Canadians and the environment from the threats of chemical pollution. Today we'll be working on river otters, as river otters are good bioindicators of ecosystem health, being closely related to the water, eating a lot of fish. And at the same time, we're bringing in youth that will share the experience with us, get their hands dirty.
So you'll hold it and you'll take the scalpel and just kind of cut away without piercing the skin, super gently. So hold it there and then start cutting away at it, carve it up.
These?
Yeah, that's perfect.
Sharing knowledge, both from an elder and a youth perspective on some of the changes that they see, and also sharing the Western science knowledge, what we do, why we do it, some of the skills that we have. We love training a lot of these community-based monitors to carry out the work.
So why do we collect livers? Because whenever you eat, it's digested into your stomach, it's sent to your small intestines, it's mixed with acids at that point. And then from there, the little blood vessels in the intestinal wall, they come and they absorb all of the good stuff out of the food. And then it's sent to your liver, and the liver will basically filter out the bad stuff and keep only the good stuff. So we look at liver because it's a filter organ. So it really filters the blood, takes all of the bad stuff out, and this is where we find it.
It's a win-win situation. I mean, there's no one that's better equipped at doing these collections and processing these samples than the people that live off the land. So by training them and giving them access to these skills, then we build these partnerships and these collaborations that are really successful in helping us ensure that the work we do is meaningful.
Learn more in part 4 as Phil Thomas heads back to his lab in Ottawa to process the samples collected for his research and see how the results are stacking up. This video series was made possible through funding from the Oil Sands Monitoring Program and was produced in collaboration with the Mikisew, Cree, and Athabasca Chipewyan First Nations.